charge God foolishly. He never sinned, because the day that he was born, but he never cursed God. Even when his wife, the one closest to him, said, "Why don't you just curse God and die?" He said, "Lord, you talk like a foolish woman. I would never charge God." See, you know, there was something going on in the background. And that's what I want to bring out to you. The devil was busy. See, you think of your church, you say, you say, no, you're not saved. God is saving God.
Yes, Lord.
Because while you were walking to and fro looking for somebody, God stopped him. Now I would ask the question, why would God stop the devil? He's an adversary. And God asked him, "Have you considered my servant Job?" And then, you know, because that girl phrase says, the devil must have looked at God like, "You got to be joking. I'm the devil. Now how can you ask me, have I considered it? I've been considering. But you have an edge about it, okay?" So he not said, "I'll move that edge."
Yes.
He's talking about that now.
Yes.
What goes on? Listen carefully. He moved the hedge and gave him a strict order. Do not mess and bother his soul. But you can touch everything else around Job. Everything.
Jesus.
And we know of one circumstance to another. Before he can get out of it, here goes the circumstance. Run. Job is dead. Job is the servant dead. Job all the cattle dead. Job this and Job that. Well, you know, I can imagine, okay, I can get wealth again. But then the devil was alive. Now listen at me. Some of these Holy Ghost overfilled people. He allowed the devil to afflict his body.
Yes, Lord.
I used to wonder why.